Ashkenaz. Black bees came to make it hotter. We beat the fire starter. Bubbling up just like lava, heated like a sauna. Penetrating through your body armor. Rhythmically we massage ya. With hip hop mix up with samba. With samba. So yes, yes, y'all. You know we never stop, we never rest, y'all.
Well, what an entrance. Okay, so I think I'll take you guys through things as it's been like from day one. So I had a safe flight. I flew from Gatwick to I can't pronounce. Basically, it's just this airport, the international airport in Rio, and which was a cool flight. In terms of me not having any issues per se. Whew. But let me just say, yeah. Listen. Tip number one: sitting at the back of an airplane may not be the best idea. So when I was checking in and choosing my seat, I thought that I was being smart by getting a seat at the back of the airline. Cause I was like, listen, I have got no time for kids, be crying, it's 11, it's like what, 10 and a half hour flight. I just want peace and quiet. And I know that they tend to put kids at the back at the front of the plane where they have enough leg room and blah, blah, blah. Okay, so I choose that seat thinking I've been smart, right behind where the toilets are, so easy access and stuff like that. Yeah, so get on the plane now. I think there was one gentleman at the time. It just was a normal passenger. The way that they designed the airline was kind of rubbish, in that there was some where there would be a place to put hand luggage, the doors wouldn't open, or they hadn't, that wasn't actually a functional area. So that meant that everyone had to kind of put their baggages elsewhere. Of course, it's like, why are we putting in baggage where other customers or other passengers would put them? So it's like, you're not putting it where you're sitting. So one guy was just saying like, look, this is ridiculous. Why are we putting baggage away from where we're sat? Which was, to me at the time, was like a valid point. And I was like, you know what? The guy's making a point. I don't know when it actually began, but he just kept having a problem with the air hostesses. Like, he's literally begging for attention now. And we were just like, what is this problem? What's wrong with this guy? So I'll let you watch the clip, guys, and you tell me, like, at this point, is, in your mind, what would you be thinking about? Like, it's just getting too much.
Look what's happening with my hand! I'm in the air traffic! What are you? Yeah, because look what's happened to me! You cannot stop me! Allowed to circulate.
So the plot continues, okay? The plot thickens. The guy is talking to one of their security guards, and there was like four that I clocked, but there may have been more. And then when it got to the climax of his shenanigans, yeah, they had to the security guards were like, mate, come and sit with us at the back of the plane. And at this point, we were like, okay, now I know who you are. You're the air marshals and you're taking over. And the guy was like, he realized that he just was in a bit of trouble. So he was like, am I gonna die now? Is this the end of my life? Because they took him to sit at the back. They moved some customers. They put them at the, like, two rows to the front from where they were sat. And then he sat with the guy. And then I don't know at what point they handcuffed him. I think it's at the point when he starts to shout. I'm kidding, I kid you not, I'll show you. He was shouting.
They're probably gonna just divert the plane.
I told you, look this guy, she's pulling me this way, she's pulling me this way. Look what's happening with my hand. Look what's happening with my hand. Why are you pulling me? Why they pulling me across? Why they pulling me across? Why they pulling me across?
I was becoming distressed. A lot of customers were becoming distressed. He is shouting on a plane. The captain of the flight, I think that's the name, was like, listen, we are hearing complaints of a customer that, and he is harassing our air hostesses. If this passenger does not, like, if we may have to divert the plane, if this passenger doesn't calm down, this, that, and the other, and it, like, basically, I think they would have to take this passenger off the plane and he would be charged for the diversion. At this point, guys, we must have been, I think it would have been one third of the way there. So we were like 4 hours into the flight. We've got 6 hours to get to Rio. The closest country we are close to is Nigeria. We're like just reaching the Atlantic. I'm thinking, where are you gonna do the diversion?
Are we landing now? Because everybody's
going. You're gonna do a crash landing in the water? So I was thinking, like, what is this guy gonna do? He's gonna take us to Nigeria to kick this guy off? Oh, and I was like, look, no, this cannot happen because I have to get to where I'm going. Because we're arriving at like 7 p.m. in Rio, and I'm not that confident, you know, I'm not that secure as to where I'm going. So if we have a diversion, that means we'll arrive later. That means that already I wasn't too fond about arriving at night. Prayer works, guys. 5 minutes after praying, sat down, things simmer down. It's as if nothing had happened. Okay, God work. God is real. Let me just tell you that. God is real. So yeah, we land. No, wait. So he calms down. And for the rest of the flight, I think he was calm for like three hours. Like, it was calm. And then maybe he tried, like, there was a point when he tried to, you know, tried to start up his nonsense again. And I was just like, no. One thing about being out here is just that. It's just me learning to not be intimidated. And of course, being safe and being wise. So yeah, I will leave you with that, guys. That's my mini story time. There is so much to share, but I don't want to overload you guys. Don't forget to like, subscribe and comment on the video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. I'd love to hear more of your comments. So yeah, keep it look, guys, keep it fresh. I hope to see you on another video, but for now, ciao.